Good morning, all of you. So today we'll explore the problems related to the springs concept. So some different types of numericals I'll pick up. So as we have seen previous class, it was related to only some basics of spring, like what is the energy stored in the spring, and the spring force was a conservative force. When spring force does positive work, when it undergoes compression, and it does negative work when it is getting elongated. And already you know regarding the spring force here. Then what about the energy stored in the spring, half kx square, and it's a conservative force. When spring force does positive work, potential decreases. When it does negative work, potential increases. These are all the basics we took. Then we had some problems related to that. What about the work done to extend by x that one? So then the ratio of u1, u2, u3. So all that we have discussed here. Then afterwards we went for a very small basic idea. That at equilibrium, what do you mean by mean position? Net force should be zero, and the block will have maximum speed or kinetic energy. And at extreme, what is the situation? And at extreme points, the net force will be non-zero, and the kinetic energy of the block will be zero. I think these are some very core ideas of the spring. What all we are going to discuss today's problem, no? The same thing I'm going to carry on. Just different numericals. The numericals will be different here, but the basic ideas will be same. Only just application of the basics is what we are going to learn today. Okay, let me. So it's some infinite array. So it's like an infinite array. Means like this, you can keep on draw them. You extend this. Here again, one more spring, again Planck, like this P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, till infinity. Then we have to calculate find the displacement of the plate P1 when vertical force F is applied. So first, what we have to do, we have to search for the equivalent spring constant. Plate P1, are you able to see? Plate P1 is this one. So on you can see that there's an infinite array. So like this, we can keep on introduce the plate sign spring. Symmetrically, it will be about this middle spring. Increase the array here. Now, where do we see? Nowadays, I think you see the bed, no? The bed or the sofa set, the springs are brought, no? Almost the spring series parallel method is what is being applied here. It's a wide applications, this one. So just I pick one of the case here. So if you see this particular thing, so can we replace this part within one equivalent system? And the left hand side with an equivalent system. I'll find out the equivalent of all this LHS array and RHS array. And that equivalent, how it will come? It will be in parallel with this one middle spring force. So the middle spring force is what I left it. So what we should do, all that LHS array, RHS array, equivalent has to be determined. And more, it's a symmetrical, no? Are you able to see? It's a symmetrical. So then, what is the basic method here? So I'll begin. This will be, so what is the total spring constant of this, of this side? So let it be equal to x. And as it's symmetric, the total spring constant, let it be, x is not elongation, it's a spring constant here. So, or we'll do one thing, some other x is elongation, we took it, no? K is there, no? So we'll write it. Some K naught, I'll write it. What is the total total spring constant of the right hand side system? K naught. The left hand side also should be K naught. Okay, we'll agree this. So then what we do is this zip. So what all you do analysis for the RHS will be same for LHS also. So this is the for the array, so it is Keep it like this. So now this will be the plate P2. This is a plate P1, this is a plate P2. So here this is K, this is K, this everything I'll call K0. So what I did is total is how much will be K0, no? And it's saying infinite. Instead of finding out this total is K0, even if I measure here also will be K0 here, because in a bucket, what is the volume of water? 10 liter. In that, if you just take it out some spoon, some amount of water with a spoon, still what you say volume is going to remain same. So what you measure here, the total spring constant will be K0. And if you measure here also, it will be K0 only. The same thing what we are going to apply this for resistor, capacitors, inductors, or any other system. For infinite array, the method is same. So what is the like an idea involved in this? In a bucket contains 10 liter. If you just remove 0.001 liter, still what is the amount of water? Should be 10 liter. So effective spring constant on the LHS or RHS array, let it be K0. And what I find out here, let me assume this is also equal to K0 here. So what should be the basic equation now? These two, how they are? They are parallel. They're parallel, and that effective will come in series with this. Then this everything should be equal to again K0 only. I'm not disturbing this one. Are you looking this one? I'm not disturbing. I'm trying to replace this part here. You can see clearly in the diagram. This is. Okay, fine. Look at the, some of you are asking doubts are what actually you're doing. Okay, fine. So this is the, so now effective is how much equal to K0. Okay, now simplify it. So what is this K0 should be equal to? These two are in parallel. So effective will become K plus K0, and this effective of these two is in series with this one. No? So you are going to multiply it. K by K plus K0. Let's solve for this. K0 K plus K K0 K0 square K square K0 K. So K0 square K0 square is, so one K K0 will cancel out. So K0 square plus K K0 minus K square equal to 0. Solve for, let's solve for K0 here. So this should be K0 is equal to minus K plus or minus K square plus 4K square by 2. So let's consider the positive values only. So positive values of this will be K root 5 minus 1 by 2. This is what the of the array here. So same thing LHS also it will be. So next what I should do, this is a plate, no? Let's come to the plate here. This is the spring. So what we replace, that K0 will come here. And that K is here. And what we replaced, K0 is here. So this will be the system. So now he's asking what is the elongation. So here, this is what? So what is the elongation? Elongation, the spring F should be equal to, and how all they are? They are parallel, no? Be like this. So this you substitute now the value of this root 5 1 plus K. This will be K root 5. So what is the elongation now? F by K root 5. Displacement of plate P1. effective spring constants. This will be like this when you get infinite array, no? Like the same thing, I think you have a problem. Infinite pulley also. I think I forgot to discuss. So when time permits, no, I'll discuss that also. Infinite pulleys are there. How to replace that with an equivalent pulleys. So again, the same concept when you go for the resistors, infinite circuit will be there. Infinite network, infinite capacitance circuit, infinite cells, infinite inductors. Everywhere the method will be same, what I just told you. Okay, I'm scrolling down. Anybody taking screenshot, please hurry up. Okay, let's go back to some this one, maximum elongation. This is something very important. Where do we use this application? When you enter into the collisions, we need idea of this maximum elongation, maximum compression. Just we are making ourselves ready for the next coming chapter, the collisions. In the collisions, the idea of the maximum compression, maximum elongation is very much needed. That's why we are taking help of the spring here now. Because in elastic collision, we need idea of this one. The problem will be of this kind only. Elastic collision means you have to assume just this basic condition. Okay, read the question now. Two blocks are there connected by a spring and kept on smooth horizontal surface. Initially, the spring is relaxed. The block of mass M is pulled by horizontal force F as shown. Find maximum elongation of the spring. So initially they are at rest. Initially, what is the state of them? They are at rest here. Now, when I start applying force, so first open the block M1 will shift. No? When the block M1 shifts, then the spring will get elongated. How the spring force on the M1 will act towards left. Then the spring will get elongated, spring will elongate it, and because of spring force acting on block M2 also will start accelerating. Then how to bring that maximum elongation idea? Previously, we took conservation of mechanical energy. Can you remember vertical spring? So here, okay, let me proceed here. So again, as we enter to coming chapters now, we can, so instead of this, let me just choose a particle. It'll be easy for me to. Just let me give a particle. It'll be easy for me to initially did the condition. So I'll apply a force F. Then, so here it will get. So there's some elongation I'm showing. So because of this elongation, so the spring gets elongated. Okay, now what about the force on acceleration will be in this direction. So the first block M1 will shift, no? It will elongate. And because of elongation, now the force, spring force will act on the particle M2 and it will also get accelerated. So here first O will move the M1. So it has acquired also the velocity, no? It has also acquired a velocity because of displacement and this is still at rest, let me see. And it has acquired also the velocity. So let that velocity be say V1. And what is the state of M2? M2 is about to move. And M1 what happened? It got displaced. So because of acceleration, it has acquired velocity. And now, look at the spring force here now. So continuous load point, because of acceleration, the elongation will further increase. So here, Kx2. Kx2, this is F, this is M2. So here it will have acceleration A2, it will have velocity, let it be V2. Now this, okay, I'll write V1. odd numbers, I'll pick up odd symbols for the M1, that one. So this is M1, this is M2. What is the state of this? This starts moving. Because of spring force acting, this will also accelerate. Let me take the velocity here. So what will be the sequence now? Look at this, as it keeps on accelerates, this one. So at one instant, shall I say that as elongation increases, at one instant, what when the spring force will become equal to applied force, and at that instant, what when the velocity of the block M1 will be maximum. And look at the block M2, what is the situation will arise? The spring force is constantly acting on it. The speed of the block M2 should continuously increase, no? So at one situation, what it arises here is, this is kx3. So let it have velocity v3. Here it will v4. Here it will have velocity v5. So what I see that it starts undergoing retardation. Some a3 you write it. The symbol accordingly I'm choosing. Okay, let this be A3. Here, let it be A5. It starts undergoing retardation. And what about this? It will continuously accelerate. A2 dash or A3. This is A2. A2 dash, you write it. So next, again, what will happen? Now what happened? The velocity of the block M1 start decreasing, no? Because of retardation. Because now KX3 is greater than F. And what happened to here? The spring force here, what happened, continuously accelerate it. The speed of this will increase. So still, what is the situation here? If you compare here, V1, V3, greater than V2. So therefore, shall I say it's elongation only? Click like this. So now also what happened? V5 greater than V4. Will be elongation. So as such now, so what will happen at one instant? Because what is M1? M1 is undergoing now retardation because I'm showing here A3 like this. And what about M2? It is accelerating. So now further what will happen? Because of this, at one instant, both will have common velocity. I'll call this as maximum elongation. Now you can ask it, sir, how you can say this is a maximum elongation. Very next moment, what will happen is the velocity of, directly I think I should bring it to you if you are, so directly come to the last two diagrams which I'm putting here. So this is the F, no? Very next moment, now look at the M2. Because the velocity of M2 will keep on increase, velocity of M1, what happened? First initially should be more, then what happened? Because of spring force increasing, the acceleration in that decreases. And at one instant, it may happen like this. So now you see that this particular situation, both are having common velocity. Very next moment, what happened? Because of, you see that KXM now will become like a F minus KXM, this will be. So this will undergoing retardation. And what about this? This will further increase, no? Now if you look at the velocity of M2, it will be greater than this one. So V6 greater than V7. Tell me what will happen. This is elongation or compression? It's an elongation only. I'll call this is say some X4. This is still elongation only. Now let's compare. So XM greater than X3. XM greater than X4. If you are getting confusion with the second and third, you can avoid it. It's not there. Just only I made you to think. So now look at this one. So what is the state of the particles here now? The velocity of M2 is now more than M1. V6 I'm putting equal to V7. So what is the state of the spring now? It starts coming out of maximum elongation. Here elongation. Maximum elongation. Then again, this is elongation. Okay, got this. So like that, what happened? It will be oscillating. Later on in SHM, we'll discuss. It's an oscillatory motion. To and fro motion is going to describe it. So after this, elongation now starts decreasing. Then it will attain a natural length. This will have, say, some velocity. It's a V8. This will have velocity V9. Then what will happen to spring? Spring starts. I'll add a page. This already I told you, we have a chapter called as a SHM, just based on the Springs ideas. And next, after this, what will happen to this one? It will start undergoing the compression. Compression means I have to show the this one. So how the spring force will be acting. So KX phi. KX phi. So now the velocity of this will be V10, say V11. V10 will be greater than V11. Then at maximum compression again. I'm showing the complete sequence. Again, both will have common velocity. So at maximum compression or elongation, when the spring is connected to two blocks, at maximum compression or elongation, what will happen? Both the ends of the spring will have common velocity. So when I think this is very important, you have to really focus on this diagram. I'm giving yellow color, highlighting it. You can see it here. So when you can say this is maximum, because the elongation the spring, so if you look at XM will be greater than X3, XM greater than X4. So what will happen? Suddenly the spring from elongation cannot become compression. So what actually the sequence of the spring will take place? Natural length, elongation increases, attains maximum elongation, then elongation decreases, then attains natural length, then compression, then maximum compression, then compression decreases, then natural length. So suddenly from elongation cannot come to compression. You take rubber band, simple idea, nothing big. The rubber band, the same situation will arise, no? Suddenly from elongated, can you make compress? No, first from elongation, maximum elongation should become elongation, then natural length, then compression, maximum compression. So whenever you get a numerical, you have to keep this in mind. Sudden maximum elongation not possible. From natural length to maximum elongation. What is the sequence? Natural length, elongation increases, maximum elongation. Then elongation decreases, then natural length, then compression, maximum compression. So this is what happens. So like this, what happens? The system is executing simple harmonic motion. We can find out the time period of oscillation. This will come under the idea of reduced mass system. There we'll discuss about the time period of oscillation. Time being, what is the question asked? To find out the maximum elongation. So let's take help of the theoretical background. Okay, let's do the thing that one. This is M2. This is M1. This is F. So let the axisation of this be A1, this be A2. Somewhere here, elongation, let it be Kx. Then what is the equation you can write? A1 equal to F minus Kx by M1. What is A2 equal to? Kx by M2. Let me go for A relative. A1 2 equal to A1 minus A2. F by F minus Kx by M1 minus Kx by M2. So F by M1 minus of Kx M1 plus M2 by M1 M2. So this is what A relative I'll call. This further A relative, I'll write it as V relative dV relative by dx. Now this everything, let me call that as mu. Later on I'll replace it. M1 M2 by M1 plus, let me call mu into this is x, no? So now let's go for that calculation of Now, what is V relative? Relative velocity between the blocks. Initially, and at maximum elongation, what is the state of them? What is the relative velocity between them? There's a maximum elongation. What is the relative velocity? Will be zero, no? Clear this? And what about initially? What is the relative velocity here? Shall we take help of this condition? So when the elongation in the spring is zero, when the elongation in the springs is zero, the integral limit will be, when the elongation in the spring is zero, what was relative velocity between the blocks? Zero. At maximum elongation, what is again the relative speed between the blocks will be zero. So this quantity on LHS will be zero. F xm by m1 k mu xm square by 2. So when xm get cancelled, so therefore what is the final? xm is equal to 2 mu f by m1k. What is mu? M1 M2 by M1 plus M2. Okay, this will be our maximum elongation in the spring. So suddenly from, so again, once again, I'm repeating the core idea. Natural length. Elongation increases, maximum elongation, elongation decreases, natural length, compression, maximum compression, then compression decreases. So suddenly from elongation, it cannot attain the maximum, from maximum elongation, maximum compression not possible. So how do you can say this is maximum elongation? I think it's quite very simple. No? Look at the velocity V6 greater than V7. So what will happen to spring now? It comes out of maximum elongation here. Here elongation increasing. How do you can say, sir, this is maximum elongation? Very next moment here, the velocity of M2 is more than M1. So the elongation start decreasing. So therefore here only maximum elongation is possible. So what is the V relative will be zero. Is a very core rather than numerical. It's a basic idea which we are going to use in collisions. Okay, at extreme points, so what should be the block connected when a spring connected to a block at extreme points, what is the state of block? Block should be at rest, kinetic energy should be zero. Spring force will be maximum. At mean position, spring force will be zero. Then the block will have maximum kinetic energy. When two blocks connected by spring at maximum elongation or compression, V relative will be zero. These are some all basic ideas you must remember. Now similarly, there was smooth, no? There was smooth, surface was smooth. Now I am bringing the rough condition. Read the question. Two blocks M1 and M2 are connected by a spring and kept on rough horizontal surface. Find the minimum constant horizontal force acting on block M1 to just shift the block M2. Mu is same for both. What minimum horizontal force you can apply on the block M1 to just shift the block M2. Today, what all I discuss, they are not numericals. They are just the basic fundamentals of a spring. Of course, in books open, we just say spring force, conservative force, U equal to KX squared by 2 will wind up. But the concepts are hidden in numericals. Here, what is the condition given for us? The block. So I'll pull the force. So what is if when the spring will get elongated? Only when the applied force, at least it should overcome the friction, no? Mu M1 G. Let mu be the friction here. first when the block M1 will start shifting, when the applied force overcome the friction. So I applied a force where, and what is the initial state of them? Rest that one. So I applied a force. Then from rest to rest, it got shifted. Then I applied a force such that I'm able to overcome the friction. Mu mg. Then what about the spring force? Spring force will act like this. And here the spring force. Now this spring force, can it shift M2? So when the spring force M2 will shift it. Only when the spring force is greater than, is able to overcome the limiting friction mu M2g, that one. And here, what is the state of M1 when we are doing that one? I'm pulling it from rest to rest gradually. I'll apply force, M1 not moving. Again, I'll increase force. Now I apply force which is just greater than limiting friction. Then the block M1 shifts. As it starts shifting here on the LHS, what happens? Spring force will increase, no? So this force now, together these two will balance. And what is the state of M1? M1, what happened? Will come to rest here. So from rest to rest, I'll be moving. Gradually, I'll increase force. Then I'll see that M1 will shift. Again, like this. So the block M1, what happened? Will be pulled like this. Not like sudden. I'm not increasing sudden. So therefore the condition put constant horizontal force means I'll apply force. M1 will not shift. Then I'll increase the force. Then when F greater than mu M1g, M1 will shift. As it starts shifting, the spring force will increase. So what will happen to the block now? So from like a motion, what happened? It will come to rest here. Then I'll check it. The spring force greater than mu M2g, no. Again, I'll move the block from rest to rest. Then again, I'll check the spring force. Is it able to overcome? So this sequence is what? It is taking place here. So let's take this one. So when block M2 shifts.
Sir, can you repeat what you have just said, sir?
Here, the M1, what will happen? I will shift like this. To shift it, what happened? At least I should apply force greater than mu M1g. So I applied a force greater than mu M1g. So from rest, I'll bring like this. Then when I shift it by distance x, then the spring force, how much will act? Kx. So what is the state of M1? That's what we have to ask ourselves a question. The state of M1, what happened, will be at rest here. Sir, how come you applied force? Yes, I applied a force greater than mu M1g. As the block starts moving, spring will get elongated. So then here what happened? The block, what happened, will undergo retardation and it will come to rest here. Then I'll check the Kx value. What is the Kx? Is it greater than friction? No. So what again I do? It's a test. Again, I'll further shift it. So what is the state of M1? How I'll be moving from rest to rest? Means not like sudden, gradually.
Sir?
Yeah.
So you're saying you're moving that block slowly, right? Like acceleration is almost zero.
Better you say gradually. So yeah, the sequence, what happens is like this. Look at the spot how I'm moving. It'll be like this. Then one value of F at which this block M2 will shift. Fine here. So that's what that minimum is asking. So I have to search that minimum like this. So what happens if block M1 accelerates, it will not become minimum. Are you getting now? Then you are going to write the equation like F minus Kx minus mu M1g equal to M1a. So definitely the force will become greater value. So therefore, since he has asked minimum, no? So therefore, when M2 is about to shift, what should be the state of the block M1? Should be at rest. And anyway, this is about to shift, no? So block M2 shifts when Kx greater than mu M2g. So that this word having a lot of weightage. Huh? Block M2 shifts, this is the thing. So here, now what about the force? External force, will it do any work? Yes. Work done by external force, F into dx. Then work done by frictional force, mu M1g dx. Work done by spring force, kx dx. It was at rest. Finally, it is at rest. Initial kinetic energy, all will do one thing. KI. So what is the initial? Initial kinetic energy, that will be zero. F into X. So solving this, we'll get mu mmg plus kx by 2. What is the value of, minimum value of F? F will become minimum when you substitute kx equal to how much? Mu m2g by 2. Sir, if it is a smooth, if M2, if the friction between the block M2 and the ground is zero, tell me in that case, what shall I write? I should apply force greater than mu M, you know, because when M2 will shift, when spring force is non-zero, for the spring to get elongated, there must be some elastic potential in the spring. And from where do it will come? By external force. So what should be the applied force? Should be greater than mu mng, no? Getting this one? So it should not be equal to mu mng. It should be just greater, because x should be non-zero, no? It should be some finite value. Because some force acts on the block M2 will shift here. So when block M2 is kept on smooth surface, I should apply force more than mu mng. You do have one question in Pathfinder. Just try that. If not that, I'll help you later. Okay, no, this is. Read the question. There is an acceleration. So it's asking maximum elongation where one end is accelerated. I think that the diagram, I'll put it here. It's asking maximum elongation. Find the maximum extension in the spring. Earlier, force, okay, no? Now, one end, I'm pulling it, this particular A. So what is it? It's a natural length. There is initially this one. So one end of the spring, I'll hold it. I'll start accelerating it. So now I'm asking you, what is the maximum elongation in the spring? Again, maximum elongation, what is the basic necessity condition? Both the ends of the spring must have common velocity. Extension means elongation only. Huh? Extension means elongation only. Whenever spring comes, you have to draw diagrams. So draw diagram means you have to analyze situation. What will happen next? What will happen next? What will happen next? It's not something writing equations. You must analyze the diagram. Looking at the diagram, right set of equations will be in better position. you can do in ground frame. Let me do with respect to the point A. Point A is accelerating. No? Let me do in the point A frame. So initially, what is this? The point is accelerating. I'll proceed like this. So I'll just make the problem everything very simple by doing in non-inertial frame. There's one problem, I just took it. Okay, this is the point A, that one. So let me work out the problem with respect to point A. So this is the point A. We know point A is accelerating. Then initially, what is the system? It is so spring is relaxed here. This is at rest. Then, as the point A starts accelerating, a pseudo force should act. No? So pseudo force will act. Then, because of pseudo force, this will block will accelerate. Then I'm describing with respect to point A, that one. So spring force will act here. So it will acquire velocity V1. It will accelerate, no? The block will accelerate. Why A1? Because definitely MA0 will be greater than KX here. Then at one instant, the pseudo force is able to, the spring force will become equal to pseudo force. Then it will have maximum velocity. Then next, further, what will happen to block? Now this is a mean position, no? You can call this a mean. So here next it will undergo retardation. Spring force, call KX1. I'll shift this. Next, after this, what will happen? So the block is undergoing retardation. So finally, it will undergoes retardation. Okay, this is it. So here, pseudo force, and this is what that maximum elongation. And what is the state of this? Should be at rest, no? So how you can say it is at rest? Go back to the springs idea. At extreme points, at extreme point, at maximum elongation, what should be the state of the block? Should be at rest. And that mean position, maximum velocity, net force will be zero. This is a mean. This is like a right extreme. This is a left extreme. With this, in the frame of reference A. So where we are doing with respect to A is continuously moving, but I'm describing motion of the block. Motion of block with respect to end A. And what is end A? Is accelerating. Okay, now tell me like, what actually going on here. So what we have to find out, we have to get this maximum elongation. Look at the question, is asking maximum extension or elongation. So whose help I should take here? What are the forces that are acting? Pseudo force and spring force, and from rest to rest. So according to the, can I apply conservation of mechanical energy? The answer is no. Why we should not apply? Because pseudo force is not a conservative force. No, it's some sort of like external force. So initial kinetic energy, this is the initial, this is the final. Initial kinetic energy plus work done by pseudo, work done by spring equal to final kinetic energy. Initial kinetic energy zero. Work done by pseudo force, MA naught. It's a constant of MA naught into XM. KX dx zero to XM equal to zero. So therefore this will be MA naught XM minus KXM square by 2. So what is XM equal to? 2 MA naught by K. This is the maximum extension. You do it in ground frame, you'll get it. So somewhere here, it will acquire maximum velocity also, no? So this is something very important. Here, the block will have maximum velocity. Try to check this. That's why I wrote mean. Left extreme, mean, and right extreme. Just see that. I'll scroll down. Or taking screenshot, take screenshot. Same problem, try in ground frame. Just wait a few more questions. Okay, now let's take this question. Read the question, no? Just now we have discussed the pseudo force something, no? The similar idea, you can apply it. There's a plank. On the plank, again, two blocks are kept. And there's a nail. Again, the spring is connected to the nail and the lower block. A magnified diagram. See clear. Draw the diagram and all the forces. So initially we'll start like this. So initially, what is the state of? Okay, I think all of you. Okay, now we'll proceed like this. So this is the plank. First, there's a block in one. Acceleration of plank given. So let me write it. So what is the mass of the plank with the help of friction? Coefficient of friction between the bar and the block is mu. What maximum acceleration parallel to spring can the block given? So he has not given anything. So let me write mass of the blocks be m1. Next, this is m2. And there's a plank. why lines are not coming. There's a plank and there is a spring connected. There's a need. There's a situation. Now the plank is I'll write it here. So there is a friction between, and initially what is the state of them? They are at rest. So we'll start problem like this. It'll be much easier. And what is the state of spring? Relaxed. Now I'll accelerate the plank. What maximum acceleration parallel to the spring can the plank be given, preventing sliding between the block and the bar? So directly, when the slipping between the blocks will occur, and this is rough whistling, this is rough. There's a friction between the blocks. Coefficient of friction between the block and the bar is mu. And there's no friction between the bar and the plank. Between M2 and plank, there's no friction. There's a condition. Now, as I move the plank, who will move the system of blocks? The spring force, because it is connected to the nail, no? This is nail. So as I start moving it, shift it down. We'll shift it a little bit down. Yeah. So now as I start moving it, so let the acceleration of the plank, let it be AL, write it. So this is the acceleration of plank. This is what we are supposed to find out here. What maximum acceleration parallel to the spring can the plank be given, prevent sliding between the block and the bar? If plank accelerates, what happened to nail? Nail will also accelerate, no? So this one end of the spring is I'm accelerating. Can you recollect similar problem just now I discussed? Just now, I just picked up the same problem in an order. So here, one end of the spring is what I'm pulling it, no, with an acceleration A, and instead of block, one block, we are having two blocks, and there is a friction between them. So just I'm correlating the idea what you learned in the previous problem. So work done by the spring in the plank frame, work done by the spring should be equal to what? Like a work done by the pseudo force on the like a block systems. So I'll write down this one, work done, initial kind, select it will be work done by spring should be equal to work done pseudo force on the blocks. So work done by the spring is how much? Kxm square by 2. Work done by the pseudo force. Pseudo force alone, what will happen? It's going to pull them, no? Because the spring will become internal. The pseudo force is what will be acting on that one. So what is the work done by pseudo force should be M1 plus M2. I'll write it A0. A0 into, this will be Xm. Keep in where we are writing in plank frame. So here, what is the idea? Blocks will be at rest with respect to plank. So you stand on the plank. Who is doing this problem? Person here. You just appoint a person, let it be on the plank. Then what he sees that the pseudo force will pull the block. And the work done by the pseudo force is what? Equal to increase in elastic potential in the spring. So I'm equating that one. So for what we have is this particular equation. Now let's come for in the ground frame. Let me take another person who is there on the ground. in the ground frame, what are the forces they will see? In the ground frame, what are the forces? You'll see that a spring force is acting. Then friction should act like this. And there's a friction. And there's no slipping between the blocks. There's no slipping between the blocks here. So therefore, any equation, can you write it? Kxm should be equal to, directly I'm writing it since we know this one. What is the maximum force for no slipping? There's the formula. Kx equal to mu m1 plus m2g. Now substitute this Kxm value there and solve for that acceleration a naught. So here I think one more equation will come. Kxm by 2 equal to m1 plus m2 a naught. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Substituting 1 equal to 2. How much will get? A naught equal to mu g by 2. If acceleration of Planck is less than mu g by 2, no slipping will occur. If it is greater than mu g by 2, slipping will take place. I think the frame of reference very important.
Sir? Sir, F limiting would be mu m1 g, no sir?
Oho, I'd go back to block upon a block concept. When you apply force to the lower block, what is the maximum force for no slipping? Mu m1 plus m2g, can you recollect?
Sorry, yes sir.
Describe the motion of blocks with respect in the ground frame for no slipping occur, this is a condition. So I'll write it this, who is this one? This person. Who is writing this equation? This one. I blue and red colors font also I'm giving it. This is a ground. And make it on this one. I'm scrolling down. Okay, one question will add up. One question is missing. I'll just add up that question. Okay, now we'll take this a block. This is relaxed. And initially, block is at rest here. The free end of the free end of spring is pulled. With a constant velocity V naught. Find the maximum mechanical energy of the system. Earlier I moved with a constant acceleration. Now I'm bringing velocity. One end of spring, I'm going to hold it. I'm going to pull that with a constant velocity V naught. I'm asking what is the maximum mechanical energy of the system. And maximum elongation of the spring. We'll calculate this also. And maximum this is a smooth surface. Initially spring is relaxed. One end of the free end of the spring I'll pull with a constant velocity. stick on to the basic things. Just know what we concluded, no? Stick on to that basic things. Okay, I'll proceed like this. So this block, no, I'll just show a dot like this, huh? So that we can draw the diagrams. So initially, this is at rest. This is spring. Spring is relaxed. I'll call point P. So now, so the moment I'll start moving it, so here, the spring will get elongated and the velocity of this end is fixed here. So the spring will get elongated, spring force kx1. Because of this acting here, the block will have, say, velocity v1. Why it will have velocity? Because spring force acting, because of force acting, it will accelerate. Because of acceleration, it will acquire speed when it undergoes some displacement. And this np, I maintain it constant velocity v0. It is moved with a constant velocity v0. Then further next situation. V0, this is P. So the spring will further get elongated. So let the velocity be v2. So definitely I can say v2 greater than v1, x2 greater than x1. What will happen to velocity of this left end of the block? Will keep on increase, no? Will keep on increase at one instant. Both the ends of the spring, no? Block as well as the np will have common velocity. And that common velocity, I'll take it v0. And here is, I'll call now the elongation is maximum. Now you have to ask me question, sir, how you can justify it. Look at the spring force acting towards side, further acting on the block. What it will do? It will accelerate the block. It will accelerate the block. And because of that, the velocity of the block now will become greater than the velocity of the free end. So here, call V3. This is V0. So here V3 will be greater than V0. Can you say this maximum elongation? No. So if you check it again, X2 less than XM, X3 less than XM. So where maximum elongation? Maximum elongation is possible here. Again, what is the basic necessity condition? At maximum elongation, what will happen to the ends of the spring? They must have common velocity. That's for the idea I'm bringing it here. I'll write it here only. Maximum elongation. And next, after this, what will happen? Because the velocity of the block is more than that, further, what is the next situation? Compression will occur. Compression. So next, if I go for further, there will be velocity as the velocity of the block is more than that of the NP. So next, this elongation start decreases, no? Elongation start decreases. So here, from elongation now, shall I say, it will attain natural length. Then what is the state of the block? At rest or in motion? Here, it will have velocity. So this is the, what is the, and look at the V. What do you expect the V? Greater than, what do you expect the velocity here? Is it greater than V3 or less than V3? V should be greater than V3, and there's a natural length. Suddenly from maximum elongation cannot attain natural length. Maximum elongation, then natural length. After this, what is the sequence? Now the velocity of the block is more than that. So you can see that one, V is greater than V3 and V is greater than V0 also. So now what will happen to the block? Spring will undergo compression. Here the spring force will act like this. So what is the state of spring? Compression. Okay, clear this. So what is the velocity of this? call V4 something. Now what do you expect V4? V4 will be less than V. So it is undergoing now compression. Again, at maximum compression. Like that, the sequence will get repeated here also. Maximum elongation. XM means maximum elongation. XM, the symbol itself, maximum elongation, I wrote it, no? Maximum elongation in the spring. Okay, what is our question now? So Veda is asking to calculate the maximum elongation and maximum mechanical energy of system. Okay, how to bring this? Okay, this sequence, what happens? Okay, we are able to put it. So shall we put here elongation increases from year to year, elongation increases, then elongation decreases, natural length, then compression starts increasing. How to bring that energy mechanical energy of the system here? Okay, let's go back to the initial. What are the relative velocity between the block and the point P? Initial relative speed between them. What is the relative speed? V naught. And again at natural length, what is the relative speed? The relative speed should be equal, no? Because the sequence is same, no? So what is the state of spring here, natural length? Now also here, natural length. So the natural length, I'll look at that blue color one. So what is the relative speed? The relative speed of the spring must be, so what is the relative speed? V naught. So U relative is equal to V minus V naught, and that should be equal to V naught only. Comparing what? Comparing state of spring at natural length. So what is V equal to? 2V naught. Okay, look at here, there's no elongation in the spring, so block is having mass. So what about the mechanical energy? This should be M 2V naught square by 2. So this should be 2M V naught square by 2. This is what? Maximum mechanical energy of the system. Not at maximum elongation, it will not have maximum mechanical energy. The mechanical energy will be maximum again when spring attains natural length. After this, how to get the maximum elongation one? So now let's do one thing. Come for that one. What is work done by spring force? How the block will acquire velocity V naught, the spring force only? Just look at only the this one. What is the state of the block? Rest. Now what is the state of the block? In motion. Now from how the block has acquired kinetic energy, the spring force doing work only. So therefore, work done by spring force should be equal to change in kinetic energy of the block. Change in kinetic energy of block. What is work done by spring force? Kx dx 0 to XM should be equal to MV naught square by 2. Solving this, we'll get the maximum elongation. XM equal to V naught M by K. Okay, this will be our answers. Huh? So both the I'm giving all situation when block connected, force applied, rough surface, it is moved with a constant speed, it is accelerated. You must get all these conditions. Okay, now come for this one more simple, very nice, good problem. Read that one. A block of mass 1 kg placed on a floor is connected at one end of a long spring of stiffness k. Quotient of friction between the floor and the block is mu. The free end of the spring is pulled gradually away from the block until the block begins to slide. If the block stops after sliding a distance 6 cm, find quotient of static friction between block and the floor. Previously it was smooth, no? Now I just took this to be rough. So what is initially the block? There's a block and so it is kept on a rough surface. So initially spring is at natural length. Let me have this reference line. So what is the state of the spring? It is at natural length. The question given like this, and this is rough. Let's take the problem. So one end of the spring is pulled. Who will pull that? External agent is going to pull that one. So as he pulls, so when the block will shift, only when spring force overcome the friction. So therefore, what is the state of the block? Block will be here only. So an external agent, no, yes. Let's assume that one. So now shall we take this elongation as x1? So when you produce some elongation only, here spring force will act. Then the spring force can overcome the friction. Will I agree this? This is a sequence. Now what happened? The block is about to shift. For that, what happened? The other end, what happened? The free end of the spring should be displaced by a distance x1. So what is kx1? kx1 we can write equal to mu s mg. I think this is mu s. Block is about to shift, or you can put motion impending here. So here kx1 equal to keep it in hand. Then, so what will happen very next moment? The spring force is able to overcome the friction, and what will happen to block? Block starts accelerating. Why it will start accelerating? Here motion impending, here at rest. The block starts accelerating. So this will be the, so what about the friction? No, friction will be mu k m one g, and again still show that spring force kx1. Will I agree this? I think you must have some basic idea here by this time. The moment the motion impending, I'm telling, very next moment what happened? The force is able to shift the block, and the block as it start moving here. So what is the kinetic friction will act here? Okay, now tell me what is the state of the block. It starts accelerating. So now the block will start shifting here. So here so kx some kx you write it, then here mu k m1 g, and it is accelerating. Because of this, it will acquire velocity. So tell me, what will happen to the block here now? The block will accelerate. As it accelerates, the velocity will increase, no? And at one point, as it accelerates, then at one point, again, the spring force is balanced by the this is mu k m1 g. Let me write here. So here the spring force will balance. Without diagram, you can't understand. That's why I'm just going for this one. So kx naught mu k m1 g. Here it will have maximum velocity. This is like a mean position. The force will be continuously be acting. Tell me now after this, what will happen? The spring force will become less than mu k m1 g. And what is the state of the block? Block will decelerate. Block will decelerate. And will undergo retardation. So here, kx2, let me call. Here it will be, I'm showing retardation like this, a2. And finally, what happened to the block? It will come to rest, no? I could have wrote directly equation, just I wanted to show that one. So look at the state of the spring now. So spring, what is the thing? So finally, what happened? It has undergone displacement of how much? Equal to S. This he has given. And here what happened? The spring force will be acting here. So sir, call say some kx3. This is the elongation x3, I'll write it. And this is what? Say L naught for our convenient. And what is the state of the block? Again, it has come to rest. Why? Because undergo retardation, the spring force will become less than the frictional force will undergo retardation. And for a moment, let it come to rest here. Okay, now how you can write overall the set of equations. So just I think the diagrams. All the point of application. Okay, fine. No, so look at the total diagram. Situation is what I'm showing it here. Can you write any equations looking at the set of diagrams? You are supposed to analyze without this. I think you'll be in a not better position to solve this problem. What all information given? First, looking at the diagram, L0 plus X1. L0 plus X1 should be equal to S plus X3 plus L0. So therefore, X1 equal to S plus X3. Now somewhere X2 I took it. X3 is what very important for us. This should be equation. Now, what about the work done? That was the question given, no? I think read question once. The free end of the spring is pulled gradually away from the block until the block begins to slide. I'll pull it until the block begins to slide. Finish or no? Afterwards, I'll not shift it. Is it okay?
Got it.
So therefore, I should bring that red color dotted line. I think that is very important. That without that sentence, we can't do anything with the problem. Okay, now any equations can you write here? It's all about now looking at the diagram, that one. So initially, this is the elongation. No? This is the elongation. What is the state of spring? Spring, I'll write it here. This is the elongation. And what is here? Here also? Elongation. So what is the, so we'll do work on the block, the spring force only. So work done by spring force should be go to what? To overcome the friction. So shall I equate anything, the elastic potential of the springs with the work done by the friction? What all see, like, see, the problem is like this, this end of the spring is pulled, finished over. I don't displace here. Now here what happened, the what is energy of system? Kx1 square by 2. This energy is what is utilized to displace the block. And finally, what when the spring has retained some energy. So what about here? From where this Kx1 square by 2 will come? By the action agent. The action agent did some work. The system got acquired energy here. How much? Kx1 square by 2. Finished. What is the role of action agent? No. Take it out. Because you look at the F, the point you see that one. Where is one end is pulling, no? That pull force will be like that only. So it's just keeping it here. Now what will happen? You will stretch and finish over. So what you should do here now, actually, if you're not getting confusion, I'm just going to fix it here. This is actually, if I remove this F, no, you'll not understand, sir, wow, who will pull that one? X agent only. So here what happened? From here onwards, you remove it. So then, sir, from whom it is connecting? You may say that it's connected to nail something. So I should bring nail, or therefore I'm just showing that F. So any work action agent will do from here? Nothing, no? Then we'll do work only spring force. So initial energy in the spring, Kx1 square by 2. This should be equal to what finally? Work done to overcome friction, mu K Mng into S plus K X3 square by 2. Okay, now what is the equation we have? Kx1 for the block to shift, what is the basic condition? Kx1 should be equal to mu S Mng. So replace X3. I think all the information given, solving it, will get the required answer. So what you can write X3? Kx1 square by 2. Mu K Mng S. X3 I can write it as X1 minus S whole square. So Kx1 square by 2 mu K Mng S. Minus K. So these two will get eliminated. So what will be left over? So we have all the information, no? And Kx1, what you can write from this equation, mu S Mng. So next equation will be 0 equal to mu K Mng S minus K square by 2. This will be mu S Y M1, only M, no? It is. Block of mass M, no? Yeah. So mu K Mg S minus K X square by 2 mu S Mg into S. Solving this, we'll get expression for mu S as is equal to mu K plus K S by 2 Mg. it's all about the situation you are supposed to understand clearly. So no work is done. Yeah, that one. Work done by F is zero. See, in Pathfinder, questions are there. Until unless you should, the background, you should make a clarity. Huh? Writing equations very easy, you see that one. You should understand the event, what is going on there clearly.
So could you once explain, so how did you get that equation kx1 square by 2 is equal to mu k mgs plus kx3?
Yes, look on this one. This equation?
No, sir, the above one.
Above one?
Yes.
This one?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Work done by this applied force. So it's just holding that end, that's all here. So what is energy stored in the spring? Kx1 square by 2. The spring force only will shift the block, no? And friction does work. And finally, it is having some energy. So Kx1 square by 2 of this initial, what the spring is having, no? That should be what? A part of that energy is used to overcome the friction and the remaining will be retained. So I'm writing that equation.
Yes, understood.
Sir, sorry, could you repeat what you have said? Why, how did you get that equation?
The energy here, the elastic potential is stored in the spring is what? A part of it is used to overcome the friction and the remaining will be retained in the spring. So I'm equating that energy.
So you're equating the remaining energy which is left in the spring.
Work done to overcome friction plus energy retained, no? Overall energy should be remain constant, no? Total energy I'm conserving, not mechanic energy. Okay, some spring block with friction we are. Okay, read the question now. A spring block system is placed on the horizontal surface. So here spring is given initial elongation. So there's some initial elongation is there. So the corresponding diagram will be of this nature. Let me take the spring. So this is the equilibrium position or natural elongation. So here, natural length of the spring, let it be this much. How much it is? 3 mu mg by k. So call this is x naught. So how much of spring force will act here, no? Kx naught will act and the block is kept on rough surface. A friction will be acting. And friction is how much? Mu mg. So initial elongation is how much? That x naught is how much? So we can write it, no? So 3 kx naught equal to how much it is? Kx naught equal to 3 mu mg by k. So what is x naught? Should be 3 mu mg. So what do you expect when you release? Kx naught will overcome friction. So it will accelerate. Then as it accelerates. As it accelerates. So the speed of the block will increase. No? Somewhere when the spring force becomes equal to friction.
Sir, he gave that initial elongation, that is x naught equals to 3 mu mg by k, sir.
No, this is, sorry, it should be, okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
This initial elongation is this much, not this one. Yeah. Or kx not equal to 3 mu mg, write it. Okay, no. So now definitely kx not greater than f. So you can see that from here, kx not greater than f. So block will accelerate. So somewhere at intermediate position, it will have maximum velocity. Here the spring force will be equal to f. kx1 equal to f here. So therefore, what is f? F is mu mg. So therefore, what is x1 equal to? Mu mg by k. I think you should just retain all these things. And now what will happen to the further? So it will keep on. So it will attain, the spring will attain natural length. Here also you check it, it will have some velocity when it comes to the, there's a natural length of the spring. If you want to write it, what is L0? For our understanding purpose, we have brought it. What is L naught? Natural length. Then when the block here, spring will attain natural length, it will have some velocity. Call V. And how the friction? Friction will be acting in this way. Okay, now. So now what will happen? Because of velocity, it will further go and compress the spring. So as it compresses, the friction will be acting in this direction. Spring force in what direction will act? Spring force will act in this direction, called kx2. And the velocity will be in this direction. So now what is the state of the block you see? Both spring force and friction are acting towards right. So what should happen to block? Should undergo retardation and finally it should come to instantaneous rest. So now what do you mean by compression? I should measure from here, no? That this. Shall I call this as compression finally? Maximum compression. So initial acceleration of the block. This is A naught. Maximum compression, maximum speed of the block. This is what maximum speed. Maximum compression in the spring. How to find out all these things? This is about the basic diagram. So initial acceleration, I think we can find out from the, just that initial elongation he has given in the form of, in terms of mu, that's all. So you should not get confused with any other data here. Nothing big. Problem is very simple. What is acceleration? One by one, well, A naught should be equal to kx naught by f. Kx naught should be equal to 3 mu mg. F is three mu mg by k, no? Kx naught equal to A naught will be 3 mu mg by k. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I'll continue. So A naught is equal to acceleration. A naught should be equal to kx naught minus f by m. Substitute this. Kx naught is 3 mu mg. This is mu mg. This is m. I think this should be equal to 2 mu g. This is our one answer. This option A, you keep it. Then maximum speed of the block. When the speed of the block will be maximum? At mean position. So this is not, red color is mean position. This is the mean position. This is the mean position. What do you mean by mean position? How to define mean position? The mean position is one where the net force should be zero, no? And the block will have maximum velocity. So what you can write it, this is a mean. So at mean only, it should be that one. Where the net force on the block is zero in spring block system, that is the mean position. So here, can we calculate x1? So what should be the kx1? Kx1 should be equal to mu m1 g. So we have idea like this, how to calculate that vm. So when the block moves from this right extreme, from the, this is rest, no? A release from rest. From rest, it will come to this portion. Between the first and second diagram, can we apply conservation of mechanics? No, friction is acting. So therefore, here I'll go for work energy theorem. Initial kinetic energy plus work done by the spring force plus work done by friction equal to final kinetic energy. Or you can just write in terms of energy here. So initial energy is how much? These are the diagrams. Diagram A, B. For A and B. Between A and B, K X naught square by 2 should be equal to work done by friction. Friction, how much of work it will do? F into X naught minus X1. Because what is the displacement of block? X naught minus X1. This should be equal to plus K X1 square by 2. M BM square by 2. So we know X naught, we know X1, we know F. Substituting all that, we'll get the expression for Vm. I'll write it solved later on. Okay, this is the maximum velocity. How to get that maximum compression? How to get that maximum compression? here, this is the compression. And this is just compression. This is a natural length. This is the elongation. I think you must have all this basic thing, that one. Okay, now how to get this X3, maximum compression? From where I should measure? From natural length. This is something I assume natural length. X0 is elongation, maximum elongation. X here, there's some elongation. Diagram B is elongation. C is natural length. D is compression. And what about E? Maximum compression. So between A and D, shall I apply energy equation? Between A and D. Now what is the initial energy? Kx naught square by 2. Then how much of displacement the block has undergone? X naught plus X3. You see that, how much of displacement here? X naught. How much of displacement here? X3. And the friction does negative work. So this should be equal to, what happened to all this energy? Work done to overcome friction. X naught plus X3 plus. And finally, some energy is retained in the spring. Rather than some integration all, no. Just I'm asking you to, what all energy is stored here in the spring? Kx naught square by 2. And finally in the diagram, here also some energy is stored in the spring. It will have compression. So here how much? Let me show like this, Kx3. It will have energy here also in the diagram E. Kx x cube by 3 whole square. Then when the block moves from here to here, what is the state of this? This is at rest, no? At maximum compression, what should be the state of the block? Block should be at rest. Can you go back to basics? At maximum here, spring block system, at extreme points, what should be the state of the block? Should be at rest. At mean position, should have maximum velocity. Try to see all the information I'm dumping here. And when it moves from the right extreme to left extreme, so what about the friction? Friction does negative work, no? And what is the displacement of block? X0 plus X3. Instead of writing some any integration method, I'm just showing in this way here. Okay, fine. So solve this. Some X3, I think you'll get it. Maximum compression, no? Will be mu mg by k. I'll write down, check later on. Okay, time left or some small problem, we'll take it. Let me take this question. I think 10 minutes is there. We can finish off this. Okay, read the question. Two blocks are there. They are kept on. There is a situation given like this. Let me help you with the diagrams. There's a block M1. There's a block M2. So what is telling the force F that should be applied to the upper cube for which the lower one just lifts after the force is removed. So I'm pushing it with this force. Somewhere, this is the natural length of the spring. This is going to help us a lot. This is a natural length of the spring. If you write L naught, it is understood it's a natural. Spring is at natural length. Okay, what is the state of spring? Compressed or it is elongated? It is being compressed, no? So spring force, how much will act here? Tx1, the weight M1g. Then spring force here. Kx1, then weight M2g, then the normal reaction. Now, what is the state of block? They are at rest. Now, if I remove this, now is it spring force greater than the weight M1g? Yes, it is. No, you can see that will balance. Kx1 minus F minus M1g equals 0. So what is value of Kx1? Is equal to F plus M1g. So spring force is greater than the weight of the block M1g. So now what are the forces that are acting here? Spring force Kx1 and the weight M1g. So what do you expect this block M1? It should accelerate, no? So it will have, it's going to accelerate. So what actually we did, as long as I'm pressing this block M1 with a force F, what happened? M1 and M2, okay, there'll be a test and the spring is compressed here. The moment if I remove force, M2 will not lose contact. Because for M2 to lose contact, so look at the spring force, how even after just removing force, how spring force is acting downward, how the weight is acting downward. So when it will lose contact, somebody should pull it up, somebody should overcome it. Who is that somebody? The spring force only. So for the spring force on the block M2 to act vertically up, what should be the state of the spring? The spring weapon should get elongated, no? So as Kx1 is greater than M1g, so therefore the spring will get elongated. So when it comes to this position, so what happened the spring? Now the spring got elongated. So here the spring force now will act in this direction. So this will be M2G. This is the thing. So here this is a natural length. What we have took it. Now what is the state of this? So definitely what happened, what is the state of spring? Elongation, and what is this? Compression. And now what is the state of the block? Block is at rest, no? This will start accelerating from rest. He's asking, find the force F, minimum force F. Let me call this F, find the minimum value of force F that should be applied so that M2 loses contact. So when I apply that minimum force, when this F is minimum, so what do you expect the block M1 when M2 is about to lose contact? This will be again instantaneous rest. when you apply force greater than minimum, then the m2, m1, what happened, will have some velocity. When the applied force is F minimum, then when m2 is about to lose contact, what is the state of m1? M1 will be at instantaneous rest. And now for m2 to lose contact, what is the condition? Kx2 greater than m2g. So let's get into the mathematics now. To lose contact, what is the requirement? Minimum, at least Kx2 should be equal to m2g. Okay, what to do? I think I'll go for minimum anyway. How to bring that F? Because this F is what needed, no? So what to do with Kx1? So let me take help of this state of the spring. So what is the energy stored in the spring? Kx1 square by 2. The energy stored in the spring here is Kx1 square by 2. What happened this energy? A part of this energy is converted into increase in gravitational potential energy and also elastic potential energy. So equating, applying conservation of mechanical energy, Kx1 square by 2 should be equal to Kx2 square by 2 plus mg x1 plus x2. Now from where this equation I brought it, what all energy is stored in the spring here, a part of that energy is utilized to rise the to lift the block m1 to height x1 plus x2, then the remaining will be retained in the spring itself. So this, you bring on this side, k by 2, x1 square, x2 square, and this is m1, no? m1g. x1 plus x2. So 1 x1 minus x2 equal to finally m1g. So kx1 minus kx2 should be equal to 2m1g. Let's take help of this one. So what is kx2? kx1, I'll write from here. So this equation 1, 2, and 3. Put 1, 2 in 3. How much will get it? Kx1 will be F plus M1g. Kx2 is M2g equal to, this is 2M1g. So what is that force? M1 plus M2 into g. This is our answer. If apply force less than this, if apply force more than this, is what you have to analyze. If apply force, if apply force just greater than, or say greater than this one, what conditions will arise? If apply force greater than m1 plus m2g, then what happened? The m1 here will have velocity. If apply force less than m1 plus m2g, what happened before? Here only what happened, the block M will come to rest and the Kx2 will not be sufficient to lift the block M2. So shall I call this is like a minimum force to lift the block? If I apply force more than this, the block M2 will rise. But when M2 is rising up, when M2 is losing contact from the ground, the M1 will have some velocity. I think the word minimums, you have to be very careful, the minimum, maximum, no? Because they will give a lot of information regarding the what we should assume the final situation. Why I should not say rest, because after this what will happen? M1g and weight and spring force both are acting. It will start moving down. So therefore I'll just use word instantaneous rest here. And what is the state of M2? This is at rest. And look at the normal contact. When it's about to lift, no, normal contact will be zero. And here normal contact. And look at the normal contact acting on the block M2. Is it a constant or variable? It's a variable, no? But as the block M1 starts rising up, spring force will decrease. So normal reaction between M2 and the ground will be varying that one. It's not a constant. M2 will be variable. Okay, this is, I think, some, if you check book, no, there are around 100 numericals are there on spring, not 1, 2. Different set of numericals are there. Almost maximum ideas I covered it. Now what are the few conclusions? At maximum compression or elongation, what is the state of the spring block system? Again, horizontal vertical spring block, at maximum elongation compression, the block will be at rest, and at mean position it will have maximum velocity. when the two blocks kept on by a spring kept on horizontal surface and at maximum elongation compression happen, they'll have common velocity. I think two different systems, so don't generalize it here. Two blocks kept on a horizontal surface, and if I pull by a force, then at maximum elongation compression, they must have common velocity. This is another thing. Spring block system, here like vertical spring block or horizontal spring block system. At extreme points, the block will be at rest. Acceleration will be maximum. You should not equate forces. At mean position, you have to equate forces, and they will have maximum velocity. Try to analyze all these ideas. When you take the problem, you have to check what condition it belongs. And it's always advised to draw the set of diagrams. What actually going on? You see all the way the teacher is drawing diagrams to crack the problem. So if you draw the diagram, no, little bit easy to write equations. Say such questions, no, or here also. What actually going on? How the block is moving? So I suggest students to follow this particular method. Because what all, why I'm suggesting you like this, because we are going to work out problems on what? Like a SHM. 70% of SHM numericals are based on springs. And in SHM, what we needed, at every instant of time, we need what is the velocity of the block, how force is acting, what will happen to acceleration, all that information needed. No? So therefore, if you write set of diagrams, no, this will become a base for your SHM chapter. This I'm suggesting. Otherwise, 10-15 problems, question, I would have wrote equation, I would have brought answer. We are keeping our SHM chapter in the mind. Okay, fine. So draw the diagrams. It's very important. Because in SHM, I'll ask you all in-depth questions. Fine. Okay, tomorrow we'll continue. Today I'll post a few more assignments, and the dot I'll put nearby the key. There in the options, no, that will be the key. Okay, thank you all of you.
Thank you, sir.
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 Thank you all of you.
Thank you, sir.